Irini Sereti. I'm the chief of the HIV pathogenesis section in the Laboratory of Immunoregulation, and I'm the senior author of this paper.
I'm Andrea Lisco. I'm an assistant clinical investigator in NIAID, and I'm the first author on the paper.
When people start antiretroviral therapy, the HIV replication is blocked. That usually leads to a fairly quick drop of the HIV viral load and then a steady recovery of the CD4 counts, because now the CD4 cells can finally proliferate and survive and recover. Now, of course, the CD4 count may not go very high. There are some situations that we call immunologic non-responders where it may not reach normal levels. But what is always sort of expected is that as the HIV viral load gets suppressed, the CD4 count will go up. So we were very surprised to run into these situations, these particular patients that we're describing in this paper, where the unexpected happened.
Extreme immune decline, the acronym EXID, is a completely different immunological response in which instead of having a recovery of CD4 T cells, there is a continuous decline of the CD4 T cells to a level that is below the one before initiation of antiretroviral treatment, despite suppression of viral replication with the ART treatment. So it's a context that we never really observed in the clinical management of HIV. We could recognize at least the immunological scenario in which EXID was observed. So there's only two patients in which we saw what we think it's an autoimmune signature that is responsible for this decline of CD4 T cells. And there is another group of patients in which we see definitely a very strong inflammatory signature in the peripheral blood and in the CD4 T cells. Now, the majority of these patients with clinical monitoring and with prophylactic measures remain clinically stable.
So we think this is fairly rare. It may not be as rare as we think, because if somebody sees only one case, maybe it will not alarm them to sort of generate a referral. It could be happening in places like Africa, and they're not being referred somewhere else. But for the most part, we think this is an unusual phenomenon and a very unusual response to antiretroviral therapy.
It's true that we made incredible progress in management of HIV, and it's true that we are able with antiretroviral treatment to control the viral replications. It remains obscure some of the mechanisms related to the reconstitution of the CD4 T cell count. Why in some patients the extent of reconstitution is absolutely lead to normalization of CD4 T cell count, while is not that satisfactory in other patients.
We clearly need to know more about how CD4 cells are reconstituted, and also how perhaps factors we were not thinking of in the past, such as autoimmune responses or perhaps genetics, may be affecting responses to antiretroviral therapy. When a situation is unusual, there has to be a very extensive investigation of the particular patient, and as we embracing, I think, the era of personalized medicine, I think this is going to become a more prominent message in many different specialties. And so every person will have to be investigated to come up with very specific reasons why a particular response to therapy has emerged.